A reading from Acts chapter 8. Now an angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Go south to the road, the desert road, that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza." So he started out, and on his way he met an Ethiopian eunuch, an important official in charge of all the treasurer of the Kandake, which means queen of the Ethiopians. This man had gone to Jerusalem to worship, and on his way home was sitting in his chariot, reading the book of Isaiah the prophet. The Spirit told Philip, "Go to that chariot and stay near it." Then Philip ran up to the chariot and heard the man reading Isaiah the prophet. "Do you understand what you are reading?" Philip asked. "How can I," he said, "unless someone explains it to me?" So he invited Philip to come up and sit with him. This is the passage of Scripture the eunuch was reading. "He was led like a sheep to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he did not open his mouth. In his humiliation he was deprived of justice. Who can speak of his descendants? For his life was taken from the earth." The eunuch asked Philip, "Tell me, please, who is the prophet talking about, himself or someone else?" Then Philip began with that very passage of Scripture and told him the good news about Jesus. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, here is water. What can stand in the way of my being baptized?" And he gave orders to stop the chariot. Then both Philip and the eunuch went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. This is the word of the Lord. That Ethiopian that Philip met that day, he was a man that was tremendously blessed by God. He had a good job. He worked for the queen of Ethiopia. Also, in Jesus' day, you know, most people, when they had to travel, they would have to walk. Or maybe some people might have a donkey or a camel. This man had a chariot with a driver, so he had really good transportation. Also, you know, books were expensive, but he had a copy of the book of Isaiah, and that too would be a blessing. And he knew how to read it too, and not everybody did know how to read. So this Ethiopian, he was already tremendously blessed by God before Philip even met him. But it's kind of neat that God had even more blessings to bestow on this man. He sent Philip to that man's chariot, and Philip taught him all about Jesus. The death and resurrection of Jesus were very recent events when Philip met that man, and so Philip had lots of good news to share with him about the death and resurrection of Jesus. Also, that man received the blessings of baptism. They stopped and Philip baptized him, and he received the gift of faith and the Spirit and the gift of eternal life, all the blessings that baptism bestows. That man was tremendously blessed by God before Philip even met him. And after meeting Philip, he was even more blessed by God. And today, his soul is in heaven, I'm sure, that Ethiopian man. And his body awaits the resurrection on the last day. Now, we know that this world can be full of trials and tribulations. But I'd like you to take a minute and think about all the blessings that God has bestowed on you. Blessings perhaps of home and family, maybe a good job, a nice car, the ability to read and books to read, the blessings of God's holy word, the scriptures. All those blessings and more are ours. The blessings of faith and forgiveness and baptism. But God, just like with that Ethiopian, he still has more blessings to give you. Each day between now and the day of your death, God has more forgiveness, more grace, more mercy to bless you with. And when you die, all the blessings of heaven and the eternal joys there will be yours because of your Savior, Jesus Christ. And one day you too will be raised from the dead to enjoy everlasting life forever, body and soul both redeemed from the grave. That's your future because God loves you and cares about you. And he has blessings for you that know no end. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Though we do not deserve your goodness, still you provide for all our needs of body and soul. Grant us your Holy Spirit, that we may acknowledge your gifts, give thanks for all your benefits, and serve you in willing obedience. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.